Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind. Now checking out. The Harbormaster Office. Except what's back here. Some stuff. There's some stuff back here. What's that place? All right, let's check out the office. I'll come back here. Actually, let me run up here. Interesting. What is this? I don't know what kind of game that is. Someone left their pocket watch.
Like this? Wrapped among the rocks.
That's a steal for some reason.
It's the inspector. Good on you, making a proper entrance.
Yeah, I figured I'd take the back way.
Beep, beep, beep. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
You gotta give me a second, there's a discrepancy.
A cursory fingerprint analysis shows this display case was recently opened or closed.
Let's analyze the fingerprints further.
The fingerprints belong to Sedrick Kincannon.
Alright, obviously. He should probably clean this display case more often, you muse. That gun on the bottom looks special. Has it been customized?
Confirmed. The grip has been modified for a specific wielder, most likely the rifle's owner. Additionally, the plasma rifle sights appear to have been realigned to better accommodate a shooter with slight myopia in one eye.
Okay.
Oh, admiring my rifle. Had it custom fitted by a woman on Monarch.
I wasn't admiring it. I was inspecting it. Chapter 3? Halcyon Hammett. The Dissonant Queen, Chapter 3. Halcyon Helen commits regicide. Some hours had passed since Helen's entry into the Dissonant hideout. She had fought no small number of slug men, destroying the abominations in singular fashion, and had met several employees from many corporations, each forcibly taken by the Dissonants for use as test subjects. One such freed captive, who called himself Hephaestus Harry, had accompanied her as she descended into the lair of the Dissonant Queen. Helen had exchanged only a few words with him and now would be able to exchange no others, as the man now lay in a bloody heap at the foot of the Dissonant Queen, who, Helen now saw, was not a person, but a tremendous mutant slug. The Dissonants, who had apparently been guarding her, were themselves quite dead and lay in various stages of mastication throughout the room. The Queen feasted on Harry's remains, but as Helen stepped forward, the monster wriggled around to face her. A true queen for a gang of parasites, Helen shouted. The Dissonant Queen reared back, opening its mandibles wide, and gave an inhuman shriek that shook the very foundations of the base. Huh. I want your hand cannon.
You would not believe how many times that ladder's come in handy. Why ladders do not come standard in all offices is completely nonsensical. Now then. Here for my alibi, I assume.
Later. First, I want an explanation for that nonsense outside. I guess we're talking about the people who were going to attack us until I charmed them.
Another murder? Drunk raptidons? Black hole birdie practicing his hacking in the middle of the street? Stop me if it's one of those, or I'll just keep guessing.
So that's interesting, one and two. I had a run-in with some slug agents, or I had a run-in with some quote-unquote slug agents.
Sounds as though you've already sorted it out yourself.
Why don't you humor me and explain it?
In short, Slug has not sent anyone to rough you up, Inspector. That would be acting against our own self-interest. Now ask yourself this. Why would anyone give thugs slug gear and send them after you?
Well, clearly whoever's behind this wants to pit me against Slug.
Right again, Inspector. But I can't fathom who would benefit from tarnishing my reputation like that. Can you?
Yeah, I do ask the questions here. If you have a theory, spit it out.
Oh, that's good. That's very good, Inspector. I like this. Dominant. Aggressive. The woman in charge.
I said spit it out.
I don't want to accuse anyone without hard evidence. Though it may be worth noting, Ludovico has motivation in spades.
So, as you've deduced, I did not send anyone from Slug after you. Nor is it likely they assigned themselves that task. Still, I am sorry for the trouble, Inspector.
With that settled, I assume you'll want to know where I was the night of Helen's murder.
Yeah, let's hear it.
Let's see. That night, I was... torturing Elliot Nasser for information on missing cargo. That was a messy one. Didn't break until nearly noon the next day. Can you imagine?
And where would I find Elliot Nasser to verify that?
An excellent question. I had his body dropped off the edge of the land complex.
How convenient.
I'm not sure what happened to it from there, scientifically speaking. Maybe it dissolved? Ultimately, though, it doesn't matter. You'd be a fool to believe me, regardless of what I told you. People lie, and I am, incriminatingly, people.
Then how am I supposed to trust anything you say?
It's as I said. You shouldn't. If it helps, however, you might consider pursuing not my means, but my motive. Why in the name of the architect would I kill Halcyon Helen? She was making me a fortune.
Bet you'd make a killing selling tickets to her funeral.
Why, Inspector, that's terrible.
I agree.
Besides, given how long she was likely to live and continue working, the math doesn't work out. I'd offer to assist you in your work, but I've a mystery of my own to solve, I'm afraid.
I take it the guy you tortured wasn't the source of your missing cargo, then.
Oh, Elliot stole from me, all right. Alas, you're right in that his was a singular, isolated incident, and as such, does not resolve a concerning broader trend. Items are disappearing from Slug storage and processing warehouse. The thefts began a week before Helen's unfortunate death, and there have been more instances since. Before you ask, I know the difference between cargo going missing and cargo going missing. This is the latter.
What's gone missing, specifically?
Nothing unsavory, and nothing Ludovico shouldn't know about, if that's your concern. I'm quite serious when I say Slug is a legitimate business. As to the specifics, I'm not sure. The warehouse foreman should be able to tell you. Before you ask, I know the difference between cargo going missing and...
You said that.
...cargo going missing. This is the latter.
What's the connection to Helen's murder?
I'm not sure. I'm only confident there is one. That the theft began mere days before Helen's untimely demise is an extraordinary coincidence. I'm not a man who believes in happenstance, Inspector. I do not trust it.
I guess I can't guarantee the theft isn't related to the murder.
I certainly wouldn't take that bet. Regardless, this will be fun. You out in the field, chasing down leads. Me, scheming in my office, preparing to unspeakably mangle the perpetrator.
I like to commit my own horrific bodily harm, thanks.
Oh, I never subcontract out that type of work, Inspector. You'll want to speak with Ella Tinsley, the warehouse foreman. I've cleared her as a suspect myself, but should she refuse to cooperate, shoot her. No, I'm joking. If she won't cooperate, tell me and I will shoot her. And do feel free to search my office for clues while you're here. Don't hold back on my account.
Before I get started...
Was there something else you wanted to discuss?
Why does Ludovico hate you so much anyway?
The original incident? Well, I made him an offer he should have refused.
Did you put a severed raptodon head in his bed?
What? No. Law, no. Why in the architect's name would you think that? Our combative relationship stems from paperwork, mundanely enough. Rizzo's contracted sublight to construct the Eridanos atmospheric complex. Had Lou wanted Rizzo's to retain full control of Eridanos, he shouldn't have skimmed the revised contract I sent him. Lou's an administrator, for law's sake. I thought he would adore all the fine print I added.
How fine of a print are we talking?
Still technically visible to the human eye, but only just. You're quite good at this. It was all perfectly legal, too, which irked Lou to no end. My power grab, as Lou called it, planted the seed of hatred. And Lou, obsessed with what should have been, has made sure to water it daily with his bitterness and anger.
You did steal what was rightfully his.
Do you think power belongs to those who submit the proper paperwork requesting it? Slug's control of Eridanos is a crucial step in my long-term plans for Sublight. The board needs to see irrefutable proof we are a respectable, legitimate business.
Good luck with that one.
Our dear administrator is certainly determined to not make that task an easy one. He's grown increasingly desperate to catch Slug with our hand in the proverbial cookie jar as of late, convinced we're involved in less than legal business opportunities.
But you admitted to me earlier that you tortured a man for information.
Not in front of witnesses, I didn't.
That's why you don't have a good alibi. I have more questions about Helen.
Very well.
Did you have many dealings with Helen?
A few. Helen was strangely curious about the private business operations around Eridanos. She said it was role research. But how much business know-how does one actor truly need for an action picture? I also arranged to have Helen supplied with magpicks, bypass shunts, and other hacking tools. She wanted to buy in bulk.
That didn't strike you as suspicious?
That she bought in bulk? Not particularly. It takes time to learn to use tools like that deftly. I wonder, did she run out of time in the end?
If you didn't kill her, any idea who would want her dead?
That is the question, isn't it, Inspector? Tell me, do you really believe Helen's death was a mere crime of passion? Or one of petty career jealousy?
I'm not willing to rule anything out yet.
A smart approach, Inspector. And yet, this murder is bigger than Miss Helen's personal life. Bigger than her latest moving picture.
You think she had a powerful enemy?
Indeed. I suspect Helen arrived on Eridanos with grander plans than promoting Spectrum Brown. I knew I was right about you being clever, Inspector. I'm glad. Because whoever did kill Helen is not going to come forward so easily.
That's wonderful that you're glad. You know more than you're telling me, though.
I might. I just might. Your point, Inspector?
Maybe I should torture you to get information out of you. It's not a good look for a murder suspect.
Am I an official suspect, then? Intriguing. I'll look forward to how it all plays out. Be very careful, Inspector. I'd very much like to see you still around for the grand finale, whenever it comes, whatever shape it takes.
Yeah, whatever.
One moment, if you please, Inspector. I've answered your questions. I believe it's my turn to ask you a question now.
Denied.
What, or who, made you decide to investigate me?
You're one of Eridanos' major players. It only makes sense.
Understandable. A man of my standing would naturally be tied up in all this, whether he wishes to be or not. Now then, did you need anything else?
Nope. What is he doing? All right. In or out?
I can take a hint.
Yeah, you take that hint. Because I'm stealing things. Oh, how'd you get in here? Now here's where we would have come in if we got in the regular door. Hi.
Make an appointment early next time.
I didn't have an appointment.
Sublight Underground takes care of its own.
Good to hear it. Guess I can't be picking that. Door the outside? All right, I guess we'll go talk to the administrator. Oh, not the administrator, the constable. Great. It's Deputy Wine Taster. Greetings.
Greetings, non-criminally associated individual. The Rizzo's constabulary is currently not closed due to a spread infestation. Bureaucratic processes are currently suspended. At present, criminal reports do not require paperwork. Please lament only in marked lamentation zones. Please speak clearly into this unit's recording instruments.
What's a lamentation zone? Did you say something about a sprat infestation?
Checking logs. Error. Informational limitations found. 2. Reciting limitation 1. Do not tell users about constabulary sprat infestation. We do not need to pay the health inspector's bribe. A 3rd time limitation 2. Do not read informational limitations aloud, especially not to any of those void damned snot-nosed guests, or I'll have you sold for parts.
I don't think you're supposed to tell us that either. So your designation is Deputy Wine Taster? What are you doing in the constabulary?
Error. Unit designation no longer Wine Taster. Unit designation, now deputy.
Do your wine testing instruments double as weapons or something?
While potential lethality of unit instrumentation bears towards 95%, violent utilization of equipment would void unit warranty. All Rizzo's constabularies must include at least one deputy constable. Among the pool of available Rizzo's employee candidates, this unit was considered the most Competent?
Competent? Yeah, that's pretty sad. You used to be a wine-tasting mechanical. What's your favorite wine?
Unit does not have a favorite wine. Unit is incapable of taste.
All right, then.
How may this unit be of service to you?
I'd like to report a crime.
Activating report writing servos. Activated. Please clearly enunciate the details of the crime.
I can give these people up from last episode, but never mind.
Powering report writing servos down. Deactivated. Report cancelled. 3.5 bits worth of power wasted. Bits deducted from Constable Keene's next paycheck.
Oh, you'll love that. I need to acquire the Grand Colonial Kitchen security footage from your archive.
All requests for security footage require a nominal compulsory bribe. Is that acceptable?
Well, hold still. I need to examine your bit processing unit real quick.
Error. Bit processing unit has been removed. Temporarily surpassing bit fee request. Funds will be requested from Rizzo's leadership with interest. At a later date, delivering footage. Thank you for your patronage. If you would like a wine recommendation to pair with that footage, please submit the requisite request forms. Is there any other assistance this unit may provide?
Nope. All right, so we're... We're gonna look at this footage. I guess we're gonna have a seat and check it out. Is a quest thingy? Wait a second. Security footage from the Grand Colonial's kitchen at the time of Helen's last meal prep by Chef Anwar shows... Okay. Because it looked like we were inside the thing for a second. That was weird. Shows the chef working on the dish, then Spencer Wolovich and bellhop Owens enter. Owens hands something to Spencer, then leaves. Spencer then appears to say things to the chef, who turns away and walks off screen. Spencer quickly empties something onto Helen's food and exits. Yeah. Well, seems like we have our... What do you call it? Our perp here. It's Spencer, right? Because bellhop Owens got the terroray gland that Spencer, Spencer wanted it. He hands something to Spencer, which is a terroray gland, and then Spencer says things to the chef, who turns away and walks off screen so that he doesn't know what happened, quote unquote. He's not a witness. And then Spencer quickly empties something onto Helen's food and exits. So either, depending on what we're talking about here, how this really happened, did he trick the chef into leaving? Or is the chef an accomplice? Your investigation into Helen's poisoning has revealed that Spencer is the most likely culprit. Confront him in his suite on the VIP guest floor of the Grand Colonial. Find out what he has to say for himself. Yep, all right. taken anything. I can't listen. Am I allowed to walk back here? Apparently, I am. Hacking skill too low. Reminder, excessive force permit paperwork due next... Oh, excessive force permit paperwork due next Thursday. Oh.
Greetings, criminal. This unit would implore you to confess to your crime of landing with an expired permit. Please explicate your defense into this unit's recording equipment.
My permit wasn't expired, Scrap Heap. You probably just scanned it wrong.
Error. Unit's permit reading equipment was updated only last week. Please tell a different lie.
You're a mechanical. You ain't got the foggiest idea whether I'm telling the truth or not.
Correct. Criminal. However, Constable Keene has decreed that this unit will remain here, questioning you every minute until you submit a confession.
You can do that.
Information on recent exchange lost. Restarting conversation. Greetings, criminal. This unit would implore you to confess to your crime of landing with an expired permit.
You know what? My permit was fake after all. Let me out of here.
It kept going even though the counter went to zero. No letting prisoners out for walks, even if they ask nicely. Alright, I wanna hack this thing before I forget. There's no door on here. That's an interesting button. Oh, it was lit up like... Yeah, it was lit up. Alright. So I think... Wait a second. I need a constabulary terminal key card. Maybe I'll find it in here, actually. Or in one of these. Well, what's her name is over here?
If I made a bet with you at the Copper Bottom last night, let's call it off now. I can't stand the taste of life's brass.
She's here. There you are, Cassidy.
Don't think I know you. What do you want?
I like boneless spratwurst.
Yep, that sure is the passphrase, even if it is dumb as hell. What's Dash's plan?
Hey, hang on. How do I know you're really Cassidy Mills and not a mole?
Because I'm gonna tell you where our package is, Hullhead.
Hey.
If I were part of an ambush, you'd have already been arrested. We're in the constabulary for law's sake. You're looking for cargo from our ship, the Rat King. Small package, wrapped in brown paper. It got moved to the shipping yard, but I'm not completely sure where.
If you're not sure where it is, how am I supposed to find it?
I'm sure some slugite knows how to find it, or has it listed in a terminal. All else fails, you could just case the joint. Might end up with some extra loot for your troubles.
I'd do that anyway.
You're back, I see. Hope the law hasn't caught on to what you're doing.
I didn't move.
Law meaning authorities, that is, not the forces running the universe.
What'd you do to get arrested anyway?
This is gonna sound a little stupid, but I got a thing about mechanicals. Don't like the way they move or the sounds they make. Gives me the creeps.
They destroyed them?
I was drinking with Dash in the cantina, when a funny-looking one trotted up beside us. Seemed like it was some kind of monster. So I started yelling, banging on it. Don't know what happened next, but I think it involved another mechanical. I passed right out then, and when I woke back up, I was here. Not the most graceful thing I've ever done.
Alright. Bye. No key card. Maybe in here. Almost like an interrogation room. Oh, there's a dead person in there. Maybe there's a key card on the dead person. Singularity Steel sawed-off shotgun. This aggressively sawed-off shotgun is a signature weapon of Singularity Steel, renowned space pirate gun hand and gardener. This weapon, just as Board disapproved as its wielder's serial, is thankfully just a prop. Otherwise, attempting to fire it would have a 50-50 chance of reaming an entire room with buckshot or exploding in the user's hands. Okay. Yeah. Not a good thing. Yeah, I want that closed. I want to steal things within hanging open. Oh, it's empty. Oh, look. It's a lament configuration. You open the box. We came. Dead person. Oh,
damn it. She's one of the good ones, too.
You know her? Oh, we got a thing. Here we go. Constabulary Terminal Key Card. This well-worn key card unlocks access to Constable Keene's terminal. The constabulary is located in the Piraeus spaceport. Yes, where we currently are.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
She does look like one of the good ones. Spectrum Vodka Orange. Alright. What are we analyzing? Her?
An aberration in the expected timeline for this organic being has occurred. Behold, the body of Maria Keene, formerly the constable of the Eridanos Atmospheric Complex.
Oh, that's
no
a constable.
Signs of life detected. Maria Keene is survived by no known relatives.
That's Constable Keene.